While trimming sketches is often unnecessary in Onshape, it can make downstream operations more efficient. With this release, you can now trim more easily using a continuous or drag to trim. Activating the trim tool, simply click and drag to trim any touched sketch entities back to their nearest point of intersection. If you make a mistake, simply undo using Ctrl or Command Z and pick back up from where you had left off. In this example, we were quickly able to trim away numerous excess sketch entities, leaving a one-click extrude operation. You'll now find a new option for controlling subassembly instance display within a bill of materials. Looking at a structured BOM, this handle side subassembly is listed by default as a line item with the parts it contains indented below. Right-clicking on the subassembly and navigating to its properties, you'll find a new option for subassembly BOM behavior. Selecting the Show Assembly Only option will automatically hide all included parts, listing the assembly only as one line item. This can be useful for imported or purchased assemblies that you want to characterize with just one vendor part number. Selecting Show Components Only will hide the subassembly and list only its contained parts, similar to a parts-only bill of materials. This will allow you to further use subassemblies as grouping and organizational tools without having them impact your finished bill of materials. When copying a workspace from the Documents page, Onshape will no longer immediately open the document. Instead, you'll stay exactly in place at the Documents page, and a small dialog will appear, allowing you to easily open the copied document if you should choose. When copying a workspace from an open document, however, the default behavior is maintained, and the copy will open immediately. You can now filter a search from My Onshape to explicitly look for feature studios. This is particularly useful when searching the extensive library of public documents for any shared custom features that you may wish to use. You may now easily duplicate a drawing view by simply holding the Alt or Option key while clicking and dragging the view. The copied view is independent of the original, meaning you can quickly change its view orientation, display state, or even activate an exploded view. The extension lines of manually inserted Centermarks can easily be adjusted by simply clicking and dragging. By default, dragging one extension line will adjust all four. However, you can hold the Shift key on your keyboard to adjust each extension line individually.
Thanks for watching. Click the logo to subscribe or see some of our other videos linked here.